started in New York. You know, New York is home. New York is where it all began. It's like everybody needs to come to New York and get up in New York. Graffiti is really like hardcore. If you cross my tag, we have beef. Street artists are more like, you know, let's collaborate and like, you know, so I covered a little piece of your tag. Now we have a piece together.
This passion for working publicly, and you can feel that in the space, and there's no commercial exchange happening.
I was here in New York when they called me, hey, we have to come to see this building. So the day after we started working, and for 7 weeks, like every day working there, we had really great time together.
I don't think that they intended to make this the definitive street art exhibition of all time and like represent everybody, but it's kind of become that.
We live in this neighborhood, so we know this building as so many people do. We've been documenting the artwork that's been going on in that building uncommissioned for so many years, and when there was a new set of owners, they also saw that there was art every day being placed on that building, and they wanted to make sure they did something to celebrate it before the building went into its next life, if you will.
About eight weeks ago, we brought together Elias Cummings and Wooster Collective and conceived of the project and started calling artists. And literally some of them jumped on a plane to come to New York City because of the power of this building.
So this art is ephemeral, meaning that the artists know that the art can change and go away a moment after they do the piece. So what they're really celebrating is that act of creating art, and like nature, it's always evolving.
I curated this wall back here, which is a group wall of 17 different artists from all over the world. I went and like picked out specifically younger people that weren't as known or couldn't come or whatever. You know, if you could send me stuff in 3 days and it's beautiful, I'll put it up. Most people just can't help it, I think. They just can't help getting up. Like a guy walked out of here the other night, put up one sticker and spent the night in jail.
I started doing graffiti when I was like 14. Actually, I'm working with a gallery in Italy, and you do art for the collectors and all this kind of stuff. It's more like a business, you know? But if you trust in what you do, you just keep doing, and you do your stuff for the street, for everybody.
It's that adrenaline rush of like, I just pulled off this huge piece and I didn't get arrested. You're running home and you're covered in pain, and it's like, woo! You know, like I escaped death or something, you know?
I weaved 10,000 rubber bands together, and I threaded all 5 floors of the building through the 5th floor to the basement. This work is all about the space in between the objects, and I was thinking about creating this spontaneous experience for the pedestrian on their path.
I think it's the most incredible street art event that's happened ever. And the energy in here for the last 3 weeks has been phenomenal. I'm really excited that the owners of the building had the awareness to let us do it. And people are bitching about their motivations and all this stuff, and it's like, yeah, okay, you know, they're gonna make a lot of money, but they could have just sandblasted the building and shut the doors. But they let us in here to paint for a month and like kept the electricity and the heat on. Five 5,000 people are gonna come to here in 3 days that never would have seen this stuff and would never have seen like 90% of these artists. This is pretty sweet, I think.